We have done two methods for solving the factorization of algebraic expressions. The first was that we take out the common factors if there are some common factors in the expression. If there are no common factors in the expression, we do the regrouping of the terms, right? And after the regrouping, we get the common factors. Now, when you're given any question, first you have to try. The first step should be you should try and analyze if there are some common terms in the expression. Now, let us consider the first question. It says 14x raised to power 4y cube plus 8x cube. Now, I am considering both the terms separately to check if they have any terms common. If we write the terms, if we write the factors for 14, it would be 2 into 7 into x into x into x and x. Also, they have 3y's, so we write y's also. Now, we write the factors for next term. It would be 2 into 2 into 2 into x into x into x. Now, what do we have common in both? We have 2's common and we have x's common. 3x's are common in both. We take out 2 and x cube common from both. What are we left with? 17xy cube plus 4. That's it. Similarly, let's start with the second question. The second question says 20a raised to power 4b cube minus 10b cube plus 5b square. We take out the factors for each so that we can check if there is anything common. The factors for 20 would be 2 into 5 into 2, 2 5s are 10, 10 2s are 20, into a, into a, into a, into a, and similarly b into b into b. Factors for next term would be 2 into 5 into b into b into b, and factors for last term would be 5 into b into b. Now we take out the factors common. What do we have common in all three? We have the 5's common, right? So I am marking the 5's. Also we have 2b's common in both, right? So we write 5 common and b square common. Now, what are we left with in the first expression? We are left with 4 a's raised to power, because a's are not taken out common, so a will remain 4. How many b's are left? Only 1. Minus, what is left in the second term? We are left with only 2. We write 2 and b directly. Why? Because if you don't write this step, you can come out correctly with the same expression. That is, if you take out 2, 5 common in this, what should 5 be multiplied with to get 10? It should be multiplied with 2. And what should it be multiplied with so that its b square becomes b cube? It would be b only. Plus, what is my last common term? See, in this everything had taken out to be common. Now, what are we left with in such cases? 1. Because every factor, even if it is not written, it has 1 as its factor. So, if nothing is left common, everything has been taken out, then what are we left with? Always we are left with 1. Now you can check your answers by multiplying it back. 5b square into 4a4b. 5 4s are 20, a4 b cube. First term minus 5 2s are 10, b cube. Second term, 5b square into 1, 5b square. So that was my second question. The third question is 2y square plus 3x plus xy plus 6y. Now you have to check if there is any term common in them, in all of them or not. We can see that in these two terms, in these three terms, there are y's, but in this term there is no y. Then how can we do the taking out common method? We really cannot apply. So what we do now is we do the regrouping of the terms. Now how is the regrouping done? 2y square plus 6y plus 3x plus xy. We take out 2y common from them, we are left with y plus 3, and we take out x common here, we are left with 3 plus y. Both are the same, so we can take them out together. What are we left with? 2y plus x. Now, is there anything further coming out common? Nothing. So this remains my answer. Similarly, let's do the next question. 7x square plus 2xy plus 63x plus 18y. Now check if there is anything common in all the four terms that is given. Is there anything common? No, there is nothing common. Why? Because this term has both x and y, but this term has only x in them. This one also having only x, and the last term is having only y. So we cannot take anything common out of 4. So we'll have to do the regrouping of the terms. 7x square plus 63x plus 2xy plus 18y. Now we can take out 7x common from the first two terms. What are we left with? X plus what are we left with here? 9. Similarly, taking out common from the third and fourth term, we take 2 and y common, we are left with x plus 9. Now we can take out x plus 9 common, what are we left with? 7x plus 2y. Is there any further common coming out? Nothing is coming out, so we leave the answer as it is. Let us do the fifth question now. The fifth question says 16x into x plus y minus 3y x plus y. Now we can directly see what is coming out common in them. X plus y is coming out to be the common part. So what are we left? 16x minus 3y. Is there anything further possible? Nothing is possible. So we leave the answer as it is. The last question says 9y x minus 3 plus 4x into x minus 3. We can take out x minus 3 common. What are we left with? 9y plus 4x. So this is how we use the factorization. Do the factorization using first two methods. Now there are further complicated questions coming up. So before discussing those questions, I will be discussing my next two methods of factorization.